I guess as part of having a safe place to practice art and the courage to show art, the extra courage you need probably when you're a regional artist, I reflect on some of the ideas of Leeton Art Society, which has been to not go too big and too far, to keep it local. It's a particular challenge in rural regional areas, because you're not bombarded by those opportunities. You have to go looking for those in the country, and I bring that up, and I think most people would recognise that. I bring that because that's part of the story of the Leeton Art Society, part of a recognition that Leeton was a town that had had culture, had a huge sporting culture, and had snippets of all the other tools that I talk about. Music's another classic one. Music's such a universal way of getting something explained into someone's understanding of people in society. But the specific challenge in regional areas is to really attract or see good art and culture. I mean, personal indulgence, I was shocked when I went to university at how cultural my peers were compared to us country folk. I was also shocked at how they didn't understand the variety of sports that we did. And Leeton has a proud sporting culture, and that's quite important, and that is a language on how to relate to people and understand people. I know when I come back to Leeton, then the idea was always going to be how can we get more culture into the town. It had some great culture, but I just knew how much more it could have, sort of. So, and Penny was already on top of that. She was in there. I was trying to wonder how to get culture into Leeton, but she was participating in it. She was doing it. So were a lot of other people. She particularly in the visual medium. And then that set about a little journey that I don't really know all the gaps in that, but the story of Penny and exhibitions in Leeton, from my perspective, the formation of Leeton Art Society, the formation of Western Riverina Arts, the ongoing success of the Penny Panners art exhibition, and culminating in this video, I tell that story, but I think what might be a really good reflection on that is basically a school exercise that my kids got asked to do, where they were asked to paint an Aboriginal painting. So I did. I participated with them to do that. It comes with a warning of cultural misappropriation, because it's a school exercise. It doesn't come from a deeper understanding of Aboriginal culture. But this is what I did, and I guess if you have a look at this, we my kids and I explored the idea of Aboriginal art, Aboriginal paintings, Aboriginal songs even, as stories or instructions or documentation of I can't say time but place. So I just show this as an illustration of that, and I guess what I've got is an abstract representation of Leeton. So there's a cenotaph monument, there's Chelmsford Place. In Aboriginal culture, we suggested that a meeting place, which was represented by this, and this is Arnie Penny's house. And in that little story of my participation in the with Penny and the culture of Leeton, I've represented the exhibitions that we had, and so I've represented the historic hydro here, the Masonic Hall here as an exhibition, the Madonna Place as an exhibition, the art house opposite the tourist information that we had, and lots of things were done there. So I just show the connection between that, my house, Ron Dempsey's house, Pam Ahern's house, different people, Pat Faulkner's house, different people who were involved, and how we were connected, trying to capture the Aboriginal sense of a set of instructions to show what happened. So I think that's a fun little story that connects in there, and I'm hoping you can appropriately use that maybe as some background.